Hey guys, Naturally Linda here. I'm going to go over your July Herbal Apprentice box. I just did a whole spiel and then I realized I didn't record it. So I'm like, so I went over I hope you enjoyed the project for this month. You can never have too many salves. You just cannot. Looking to see if somebody's trying to get in here. And so the and I had talked about just a second ago when I thought I was recording, but I didn't. When you guys get these herbal teas, you can do a lot of things with these herbal teas. You don't have to just infuse it in water and drink it as a tea. You can make this into a beautiful healing salve. You could make this into a tincture. You can make this into a glycerite. Remember the difference between a tincture and a glycerite? Well, a couple of things. A tincture made with alcohol, 80 proof alcohol, at least 80 proof, 90 proof if you can get it. It's going to have like an almost unlimited shelf life. Most people say 10 years, but in all honesty, it will last forever. Now, a glycerite isn't going to have the shelf life, and glycerite is 70% food grade glycerin, 30% distilled water. You make them in the same process. I generally use the folk method. Fill your jar halfway full with the herbs of your choice, and then you're going to pour your liquid over them, put a lid on it, give it a good shake, put it in a dark cabinet somewhere, and just shake it when you think of it a couple times a week. If you're fantastic, once a day. I never remember to do that. So yeah, but don't think you just have to use this for herbal tea. You can use this for a lot of different things. And so we made the calendula. I sent home the calendula oil, the infusion. I actually have the yarrow infusion happening right now in the house. I want to make that as our project for August. That's going to be yarrow. So, you can't have too many salves. They're beautiful. And like you can make a tincture out of this as well, a glycerite. Generally, a tincture made out of alcohol is going to extract more medicinal properties from the plant. There are some plants that actually do better with glycerin, but they're far and few between. Generally, alcohol is where you're going to get your strongest medicine. And if you're opposed to alcohol, certainly use the glycerin. I actually like that over the apple cider vinegar, but apple cider vinegar would be another choice. You can fill up your jar. But so these things I send with you, it's not, just the tea. You can do beautiful things with this. You can make a beautiful salve or a tincture or anything like that. We sent home the seed packets. You guys can save these for next year. They'll be just fine. These are the weirdest looking little seeds, aren't they, for the calendula? Or you can plant these on in a little pot and keep it on your windowsill. I like you guys to be able to have these in case you do want to plant them or give them to somebody who maybe wants to start an herb garden. That'd be a beautiful gift for someone, wouldn't it? What else did we have? We had our golden calendula soap. And here's something kind of interesting about the chickweed soap. One of my friends who I've met through TikTok and through my website, she said she had a skin tag on the back of her shoulder, I believe it was. And she used the chickweed soap and she swears that's what made it fall off. And I've been doing some research on chickweed, so stay tuned for that. I think that was our very first herb we did. Chickweed is an inconspicuous little weed, but it's really powerful. So yeah, I just thought that story was good. And Jenny shared that with me. So thanks for sharing that with me, Jenny. And let's see here. We have, oh, those little lemon honey sticks. Did you like those? I really like those. Like when I want a sweet treat, I know they're an healthier option and they are flavored with vanilla essential oils, just like a drop, but they are so good. They're so good. Just the other day, I said, Karen, would you like one of these? And she had never just eaten the stick. They are so tasty. So I also want to talk to you guys about a couple of books here. And this is a newer one that I got. It's called the Encyclopedia of Herbal Medicine. That's a little calendula flower on the front there. And it's just a really good resource. This is what we need to have on hand. You know, when people get sick, we can just open it up. We can go to the index in the back. We can look for, if we're looking in this case for calendula, and then see what it has to offer in the form of information. So a really fantastic book. That's probably backwards. Anything Rosemary Gladstar, I just absolutely love her. Love, 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 love. And have some of these books on hand. You can get them secondhand. Sometimes you can even find them at garage sales and stuff like that. Thriftbooks.com. That's where I get a lot of secondhand books, and generally they're in perfect condition. I think I got this Radical Remedies through Thrift Books. Oh, look at that. There's dog hair on it. Surprise, surprise. So yeah, have some of these things around for your resources. And I will upload this. And I'm going to send out an email. I want to get some feedback from you guys. You know, are you liking the projects? Is there a project you hope to see in a future box that you would like to learn how to make? I've heard from a lot of you, and you like projects that don't take a lot of time. I get it. So, you know, this project where we have right here, I made the oil for you. I've already taught you how to make the oil, but it's kind of nice to just have it right there and at your fingertips. So, any suggestions? My gosh, please, my door is open. I would love to hear from you. I want to continue helping you build your apothecaries and help you learn how to be more comfortable with herbs. It's really daunting. And you know, there's things that are still daunting to me that I'm still learning. It sounds like we have a Harley Davidson coming down the road. But yes. And I want to talk to you about these classes if we want to do some other kind of platform. Maybe we can go back to the YouTube. I don't have anybody on here, so I don't know if you guys are having a hard time getting in, but I am going to upload this and talk to me. Let's make this apothecary kit everything you want it to be. I do hear a lot of really good feedback, and I'm here just to help you. I'm here to learn from you, and that's about all I have for today. So I think I'm going to actually get off here and go live over on TikTok, see if I can catch some of you guys there. All right, guys, chat later, and I will go ahead and upload this, okay?